So hi, good day. As can you see, I'm here in the outside at Cathedral, Naga City. I'm here because I will discuss or I will report about leaves. Actually, leaves is important, but some of us, we forgot about leaves. We forgot how leaves grow. We forgot the importance of leaves. So here we are to discuss the leaves by my groupmates, Mr. Christian Oswald Balilia, Mr. Jubel Bibay, Mr. Jake Katingbang, Miss Danica Grapes Pacho, Miss Jinlin Repano, and of course me, Shirley Ann Vipar. Yes, we tackle about leaves and we discuss how leaves important in our environment and how leaves take care in our environment. So before that, I have a song about leaves. Not a song of Ben of Ben, but it is a composed song, not of mine. It is a song I got in YouTube and I attach here in our report to hear the song about leaves. So this is the song. If you know this song, you can sing.
Say to I could onto the ground. Little by little by little they grow and they search all around for water and ions so they can absorb. My process is called osmosis, I can transfer to move things around. If you look under their surface, transparent cells let light pass through. Absorb life for you. So palisade cells, all full of chloroplasts with chlorophyll, packed close together, then spongy mass to fill as glasses full forever. Into the leaves to help keep it cool. It's beautiful photosynthesis, a reactive process. If you look under their surface, transparent cells let light pass through. So life of you. So palisade cells, all full of chloroplasts with chlorophyll, but close together, then spongy mass fill as gases flow forever. Oh, stomata holds leg acids in and out of water, loss is transpiration, causes close sometimes to stop the dehydrating. The more you know, glucose is made when reactants mix with sunlight in the day. Norm delivers to the plant, the plant. Stomata holds leg
That's all about the structure of the leaf, and as you can hear about the leaf of structure, it has a stomata holes, it has stomata closing and opening. So that structure we will discuss also my groupmates. And everything about leaves, we will discuss it. So let's start about leaf. So for you, what is leaf? What is leaves? What is the difference of leaf? And what is the difference of leaves? So here, we will discuss the difference between leaf and leaves. Some of us, we forgot the meaning of leaves and how the leaves are important in our lives, in our life, in our environment. So as a noun, the leaf is a small, green, and flat part of a plant that grows directly from a branch, trunk, or root. So you know already the leaf. Can you see at the back? It has a leaf of coconut and etc. So leaf, the floral form of leaf is leaves. Remember, leaf is singular. Leaves is plural. The color of the leaves can leave you with some relief. So take note that leaf is not a leaves. Leaves is a verb, not a plural noun of a leaf. Don't forget that, because some of us, we forgot the meaning of leaf and the meaning of leaves. Remember, leaf, singular, only one. Leaves, plural, more leaves, a lot of leaves. So before we tackle about the structure of the leaves, the importance of the leaves, the objective of our report is to know the meaning of the leaves, to know the 3S of the leaves. What are those 3S of the leaves? Later, it will discuss with my groupmates. To know the color, arrangement, form of the leaves, and to know the uses, function, and other things about the leaves and plants. So, leaves are the main sites of photosynthesis, the process by which plants synthesize food. We know that leaves is one of the important in the plant that makes in our food. Most leaves are usually green due to the presence of chlorophyll in the leaf cells. However, some leaves may have different colors caused by other plant pigments that mask the chlorophyll, like this is color yellow, brown, green. So some of leaves are not green because of the chlorophyll and the leaf cell of this. The thickness, shape, and size of vapes are adapted to the environment. So as can't you see, a lot of vapes here, and I picked a different kinds of vapes and colors. Each migration helps a plant species maximize its chances of survival in particular habitat. So, the next part or the next discussion will be discussed by my group mates.
Okay, hello everyone. I am Jake Bigatimbang from BSCS 1A, and I am tasked to discuss one of the S's in the 3S of the leaf, which is size. To start with, let me introduce to you to our friend Kristen Christensen Ronquier, spelled Christensen space Raunkier, with the Latin diphthong ae, named ash tree. But for the sake of ease of this report, I will just address him to his last name. Ronquier was a Danish botanist who was a pioneer of plant ecology. So he was from Denmark, and he is mainly remembered for his scheme of plant strategies to survive an unfavorable season, and his demonstration that the relative abundance of strategies in floras largely corresponded to the Earth's climatic zones. And in 1934, Ronquier noticed that leaves tended to be larger or smaller depending on their environment. He went through to the herbariums of Europe and classified leaves. And he categorized plant leaf sizes in the order that you are seeing now. There's the megaphyll, macrophyll, mesophyll, microphyll, nanophyll, and leptophyll. That is listed in decreasing order and have their own range of measurements to make classification of leaves easier. What Ronquier did was that he characterized the leaves and found that they came from a certain climate. Little leaves were found in arid places like the hot desert of California, and the big ones grew in cool and cold places. However, to stand corrected, leaves also change size depending on the changing climate of a certain region. That is the case for these leaves of certain plants that you are seeing. These are infrared images of Atherton oak in A and B, and in C and D are ivory curl leaves, which are trees and plants from Queensland, Australia. These are illustrating the variation in heat loads across the leaf surface under the autumn and summer. We can see that from 87 centimeters squared in the autumn, excuse the barking, Atherton oak increases to 134 centimeters squared in the summer. So that has something to say about the increase in temperature. And the same thing happens to ivory curl. And what is more fascinating is that each classification is 9 times as big as the previous. What that means is that as the leaf size progresses, there is a factor of 9 that increases the larger size of the leaf. To give you an example for a clearer demonstration, you can look at the table that is shown on the presentation right now. Let's take the maximum leaf size of the smaller leptophyll with 0.25 centimeters squared. When we subtract that from the bigger maximum leaf size next to it, which is nanophyll with 2.25 centimeters squared, and divide the difference with the bigger leaf size, we get 0.888 to n, which when multiplied to 10 and rounded off becomes 9. So that is a way to verify, but of course this has been figured out by other scientists. Now I encourage you to solve for the other levels, be it nanophyll and microphyll or microphyll and mesophyll, and so on, as long as they're next to each other. you'll still get the same factor for each of them. If you're wondering how these values of leaf sizes that categorizes leaves are found, there is actually a formula to solve for the characteristic dimension for any leaf. That topic, however, deserves a more in-depth and separate discussion. Well, now that we've answered the who, where, when, how, and what of this topic, I guess it's time to move on to the why. So I'm guessing your question is, why do leaves differ in sizes? Well, decades ago, scientists realized that variability in leaf size was related to water and temperature. They proposed that the limit of leaf sizes were set by the risk of overheating. So when rainfall is high, plants can get away with having larger leaves. And when rainfall is low, having smaller leaves is advantageous because it makes it easy for the wind to carry away heat and water vapor. Moreover, the risk of freezing at night also set the overall limits to leaf size. So it's not just to avoid overheating, but leaf size is also affected by its adaptability to cold. In simple terms, leaf size helps to maintain the heat balance in different temperatures. But of course, the plant species will also define the size of its leaves. It is also important to know that the position of leaves in the plant will definitely affect its size. So bigger leaves that are found at the middle or bottom, while smaller leaves will be found at the top. But that is for the average for most of the leaves. And what this says is that maturity is another factor that affect leaf size. Let's take a look at Betula platyphylla, the first leaf in the picture. According to the graph, the top leaves are smaller than the size of the leaves found at the middle and bottom, but the middle is bigger than the bottom leaf size. Now, as what goes with nature, there is no way of exactly categorizing objects. That is why Betula costata and Acer mono had different measurements. We cannot really perfectly fit them into absolute classifications because they are varied. They are only responding to what is best suited for their survival. Now, another thing is that photosynthetic functions also affect leaf size. You see, for the case of larger leaf sizes, there is more surface area to catch more sunlight, like the Magnolia denudata. And that also goes in relation to the where of this topic. When there is less sunlight in a region, the plants adapt to have bigger leaves to accommodate as much sunlight as they possibly can, and the opposite happens for regions of more sunlight, like in the case of smaller size of Michelia compressa. Again, plants do not have definite measurements to them, but what we can do is understand what are causing these variations. Many factors still play in leaf size, but different set of factors will also play in leaf shape. So just so you know, leaf size goes hand in hand with shape and its structure. The shape, size, and structure of a plant's leaves are a response to the tree species or plant species' long-term ecological and evolutionary histories. So to relate the relationship of plant shape to its size, here is Jenilyn Repano.
Now, let's talk about the shape of the leaf. Leaf shape can vary considerably. The most common shape include oval, truncate, elliptical, lanceolate, and linear. You can see the different shape of leaf such as ovate, obolate, elliptical, oblong, linear, and lanceolate. Leaf trusts and bases may also be unique, with name based on their shape. Leaf arrangement is mainly limited to two basic petiole attachments. First one is simple, and the second one is compound. A simple leaf blade is undivided as shown on the left, while the compound, the blade of a compound leaf is divided into several leaflets as shown on the right. These are examples of a compound leaf. Note that there is a bud at the base of the petiole but not at the base of the leaflets. Because the shape of plant leaf is linked to its environment, assessing leaf shape variation can help forecast a species' survival in future climate, as well as its potential for planting and revegetation in various environments. Therefore, it's important to know and discuss the shape of leaves.
Structure. Each leaf typically has a leaf blade called lamina, which is also the widest part of the leaf. Some leaves are attached to the plant stem by petiole. Leaves that do not have a petiole are called directly attached to the plant stem, are called sessile leaves. Leaves also have stipules, small green appendages, usually found at the base of the petiole. Most leaves have a midrib, which is travel length of the leaf and branches to its side to produce veins of vascular tissue. The edge of the leaf is called the margin, parts of the leaf. A leaf may seem in a simple appearance, but is a highly efficient structure. Petioles, stipules, veins, and a midrib are all essential structures of a leaf. Other noticeable parts are the tip, lamina, and margin.
Now, let's continue our exploration with the leaf, particularly on its color. We can't deny the fact that color is one of the reasons why we are fascinated to the plants. But we can also observe that leaves doesn't have a permanent color as time goes by. It changes its color from green to yellow, then into orange. But why do you think this changes happens? The chlorophyll breaks down, the green color disappears. But why do this happen? What do you mean by chlorophyll? Chlorophyll is a pigment that gives plant their green color and helps plant create their own food through photosynthesis. We can see that the leaves having a green leaf, which means that the chlorophyll is present, as I said a while ago. And yellow to orange colors become visible and give the leaves part of their fall splendor. Next is the leaf arrangement. The arrangement of the leaves on a stem is known as palathoxy. Here are some of the classification of leaf arrangement: the alternate, spiral, opposite, and whorled. It is seen at the picture. The alternate, which is the leaves alternate on each side of the stem in a flat plane. The spiral, the leaves are arranged in a spiral along the stem. Opposite, two leaves arise at the same point with the leaves connecting opposite each other along the branch. While the whorled, three or more leaves connected at a node. Leaf arrangement. The leaves may be simple or compound. But before this, let us know what is the importance of leaf arrangement. Leaf arrangement is important for it increases a plant's ability to carry on photosynthesis by positioning the leaves in such a way of to maximize the surface area available to intercept sunlight.
Function. The outermost layer of the leaf is the epidermis, It is present on both sides of the leaf and it is called the upper and lower epidermis. Respectively, botanists call the upper side the adaxial surface or the adaxis, and the lower side the abaxial surface or the abaxis. Number two, the epidermis helps the regulation of gas exchange. It contains stomata openings through which exchange of gases takes place. Number three, the guard cells surround each stomata, regulating its opening and closing. Epidermis of the leaf. Function. A waxy layer known as cuticle covers the leaves of all plant species. Number two, the cuticle reduces the rate of water loss from the leaf surface. Number three, other leaves may have small hairs, trichomes, on the leaf surface. Trichomes helps determine the herbivore. Trichomes helps determine herbivore by restricting insects' movement or by storing toxic or bad-tasting compounds.
So for the recap, why are leaves so important? So why are leaves so important? It is because leaves provide foods. Leaves provide air to help a plant stay healthy and grow. Through photosynthesis, leaves turn light energy into food. That's why this is food. Through pores or stomata, leaves breathe in carbon dioxide and breathe out oxygen. It is like our human. It needs carbon dioxide to breathe in and oxygen to breathe out. For the summary of our report, leaves are the main site of photosynthesis. A typical leaf consists of lamina, the broad part of the leaf, also called the blade, and a petiole, the stalk that touches the leaf of a stem. The arrangement of leaves of a stem, known as phyllotaxy, enable maximum exposure to sunlight. Each part of species has its character, leaf arrangement, and form. It is already tackled by my groupmates about the arrangement and form of the leaf. The pattern of leaf arrangement may be alternate, opposite, or spiral. Like leaf form may be a simple and a compound. It is also like in our subject, math in English, that has a simple and compound. Also a leaf, it has a simple or compound. Leaf tissue consists of epidermis, which form the outermost cell layer, and mesophyll and vascular tissue, which make up the inner portion of the leaf. This is discussed by my groupmate Oswald, the epidermis of the leaf, the function of the leaf, and so on. In some plant species, leaf form is modified to form structures such as tendril, spine, bud, scales, and needles. So that's all about our report about the leaves, and this is the reference of our report. So that's all. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching our report, and thank you for cooperating. Again, I'm Shirley Ann Vivard. Thank you for listening. Thank you for watching our video. And if you know about leaves, you can search. If you want to know more about leaves, watch in the YouTube. It has a lot of video about leaves, and if you know more about the importance of the leaves, you can search in Google. So as a student of Sibiswa Pili, taking a course of Bachelor of Science in Environmental Science, as a student, we must take care of the plant, the environment, the nature, because it has give foods to us, and they need us to protect it. We need environment, we need plant, we need nature. Also, plant need us. So that's all. Thank you again. I hope you like our report about leaves.